My name's Rachel, and this film's about me and Chudley. Chudley is my assistant's dog, who I got from a charity called Canine Partners about 3 to 4 years ago. Yeah, and he's brilliant. I love him to pieces. I wouldn't change him for the world. He assists me to live.
Okay.
I know, I'm trying to get somewhere.
What are we looking for?
I want to kind of stay away from independence and and stuff. So I was like, but that's, unfortunately, that's what he gives, because he allows for, you know, I'm going to have to say the word, I don't want, he allows my independence to be, he allows me to be as independent as I possibly can be.
Okay.
By myself, but I don't really want to.
What is that? What is it? What is it about the word that's frustrating?
It's again because it's going. I mean, I know I've talked about it, and yeah, but it kind of feels like it's going where we don't want it to go. If I say, it might not be.
I think I understand what you're saying, because we've said that we don't want this film to be about disability.
Yeah.
Like pointing a finger at disability.
Yeah.
And we've both agreed that.
Yeah.
For whatever reasons, we both have come to that agreement that we don't want it to be about that.
Yeah.
Is it that the word independent just brings back that label again?
Independence for me has always been attached to my disability, I think.
Right.
It's always. I know. Independence is a word on its own, but it's always, you know, it's always been coupled with, oh, you can do that now. You've got more independence. Mm. So it's always been coupled with the two, which is fine,
but you want it to be separate.
Yeah.
Yeah. Practically, what does Chudley help you with?
He will pick things up if I drop them.
Find the phone. Good boy, Bear. Good boy. Good lad.
He can also open doors. From my room or any door that has some kind of tugging system on there.
Good boy.
Him to tug.
Good boy. Come on. Okay. Thank you. Have a way.
So this is his clicker, and it works on the principle of click and reward. When you first start, it comes with the click and the treat, but the click lets them know they've done something right. I'll just demonstrate to you with something Chudley already knows. Chudley, come here. Chudley, sit. As soon as he hears the click, he knows it's going to be followed by a treat. Because that's how they're trained. Again, Chudley, sit. Good boy. But they like them to think for themselves. So when you're teaching them something new, it goes, you don't actually tell them anything to start with. And they see the clicker, and they have to try and figure out what you want. When they figure out what you want and they've got it right, you click. And then, once they're doing that sustainably and regularly, and they've kind of figured out what you want, then you can start putting the word to it and start clicking every time they do it when you put the word. And then obviously click is followed by a treat, as I said. So that's how that works. And you always start, when you're training on something new, you always start from the very end of the task you want them to do. So you make them do the last little bit for them to be successful, and then you reward them, and then as they do that, then you come, so it's like a backwards chain. So they're always successful at what you want them to do. Otherwise it gets frustrating for you, doesn't it? Yeah? Oh, lovely. He helps with clothing and even my socks. What I really enjoy about him is he loves to work. He is so eager to please. And if he's not quite sure what I want him to do, he'll look at me and kind of go, well, I know you want me to do something, so I'm going to try my whole repertoire. What's that? Keep talking. Good boy. Da-da-da. Good boy, man. Good boy. Good lad. I've just finished my first year at Coventry University studying theatre and professional practice, and I'm going back in October to begin my second.
And while you were back here for the summer break, you attended a workshop called Defying Gravity. Can you tell us a little bit about your attendance of the workshop? What is it that draws you to them? So.
I like the openness of all the performances we find during those workshops, and I like to explore the naivety and the innocence and all the emotions that come out during that workshop. And I those workshops in particular always make me feel I never feel any different there, which is getting better in other places, and is a very positive experience of just being able to explore. And going back to the question before, being able to explore as a person, and that's important to me. Leaving real life outside the door when you walk in the room, just having an openness to explore. So it's just nice to have that environment where you can create and play. And everything we're not allowed to explore within everyday society for fear of being laughed at or ridiculed, or oh, that looks stupid. They were just pieces of paper, you know, they were just screwed up pieces of paper, and yet these animals, birds, whatever they were supposed to be, or whatever our mind's eye made them, they became real, and we had feelings for them. I think when you're in it, it's less so, less powerful than when you're watching it. I was wheeling down the street one day. All I can see is his ass or her ass, or get whacked in the face by the shopping bag, or get a mouthful of second-hand smoke.
I see asses. I see passes.